Hey there, Brainiacs. I'm Dr. Allie Astrocyte. That's right, I'm a doctor now. But not that kind of doctor. I finished my PhD in neurosciences this year, and I'm excited to move on to a new job and to have more time for neurotransmissions. Now that my dissertation has been submitted, I've been reflecting on the journey that brought me here. Looking back on when I started grad school, I realized that there was so much I didn't know going in. So I thought I should share some of my thoughts and advice on navigating a STEM graduate program. Here are four things I wish I'd known before I started grad school, and a few tips and tricks I thought I'd share with you all.
Number one.
Talk to the more senior grad students. One of the reasons I chose my graduate program was because it was clear to me that the students in the program were all independent, relatively well-balanced people who enjoyed their research, but still had their own personal lives. Everyone in the program was friendly and supportive to everyone else, and I wish that I had taken advantage of that more. I became very close with several members of my class, and we were an excellent cohort. But I wish I'd spent a little bit more time talking to the more senior grad students who were ahead of me in the program. As more advanced students, they had already been through qualifying exams. They'd applied for grants and fellowships, attended conferences, and many of them had started their own postgraduate job hunts. As I progressed through my degree, I found that I was often unsure of particular program requirements and timelines, and I didn't know how to navigate sticky situations in the lab, like managing interpersonal conflict or negotiating authorship on a manuscript. But there's no reason to reinvent the wheel. So many of my older peers had gone through similar experiences. If I could do it over again, I would have taken advantage of our program's peer advising group and spent more time early on asking the older grad students for their advice. I think it would have made a lot of meetings easier.
My advice?
Spend some time getting to know the more senior students in your grad program and see if your program has a peer advising group. Those students can give you insights into building a mentor-mentee relationship, accessing university resources, and finding a reasonable work-life balance in grad school.
Number two.
Talk to your advisor early and often. Near the end of my graduate degree, I found myself feeling frustrated because I felt like my advisor and I weren't on the same page. During the last year, I realized that our expectations weren't aligned, and I struggled with communicating what I actually needed and wanted with my research. In retrospect, I wish I had spent more time talking to my advisor about my research goals and my career plans earlier on, and been more clear about when I wanted to graduate. A lot of the frustration happened because I wasn't sure how to initiate those conversations, and I was partially depending on my advisor to make the first move and guide me. But every grad student is different, and I should have taken more responsibility for my own needs. There were a lot of exciting things to explore with the data I gathered, and we wanted to follow up on all of them. If I had been more direct about my plans, I think our research goals would have been better aligned. And I think I might have graduated sooner too.
My advice?
Talk to your advisor early and often about your goals, and make sure that you're both in agreement about what the process of your degree might look like. Obviously, unexpected things happen, but having a general overview will help guide your decisions as you go along.
Number three.
Ask your advisor to send you to conferences and to help you get a few publications. I loved my research, and I always enjoyed working in the lab, but pretty early on in my graduate degree, I started to think I wasn't cut out for an academic career. There were a lot of reasons, and I won't go into all of them here. Sometimes I think, though, that if I'd been more engaged in the scientific community at large and spent more time interacting with other scientists in my field, I might have been more open to an academic career. I wish I'd asked my advisor to send me to more conferences, and I wish that I'd pushed to publish some of my research sooner. I graduated without any first author publications. We're submitting my research to a journal this fall, and I'm still not allowed to tell you about my data. I was depending on my advisor to guide me in this arena, but now I realize that the things that are most beneficial to my advisor's career are not necessarily the most beneficial to my career. By holding off on publication, it may be a very high impact paper, but it's also only one paper. When I talk to friends who are hunting for postgrad jobs, it seems like the general rule is quantity over quality when it comes to publications. I understand why my advisor has taken this approach, but I'm also a big supporter of open access and data sharing. I wish that I had pushed harder for that from the beginning. It probably would have changed the structure of my project and would have given me more opportunities to engage directly with the scientific community. It also would have helped validate my abilities as a scientist. I would have had extra opportunities to practice my presentation and science writing skills, and I would have gotten more feedback on my research along the way.
My advice?
Talk to your advisor about your goals and interests, publish when you can, and spend time looking for opportunities to share your research, and ask your advisor to support your attendance.
Number 4.
I wish that I had learned how to code. As an undergrad, I had the opportunity to take computer science courses to fill some of the requirements of my degree. And now, 10 years later, I wish I'd taken them. As my research went on and my data stacked up, I realized how much easier my life would be if I had some basic coding knowledge in, for example, Python or MATLAB. That knowledge would have made it possible for me to do a lot of my own statistical analysis without depending on bioinformatics core employees, and would have given me a lot more control and personal insight into my data. It also would have made a lot of data sorting and basic analysis way easier, because I could have used a program like R or MATLAB to process and visualize my data, instead of having to do it manually with Excel and other simple statistical software.
My advice?
If you're just starting grad school and you don't have coding experience already, see if there's an introductory course available to you, or else consider taking an online course or picking up an intro book on the subject. Learning it early on will literally save you days as you start to pick apart your data. And now, some lightning round tips for incoming grad students everywhere. Choose a lab and an advisor that values people and not just projects. Even the coolest research project will be miserable if you can't stand the research environment and your advisor sees you as a tool instead of a person. Check out the description box below for some links to documents that can help make that process a lot easier. Invest in at least one outside hobby, something that makes you feel happy and productive, because it will help you get through the rough patches in your research. I kept a garden plot and did a lot of cooking in grad school, and I made this entire YouTube channel. So even after a bad day in the lab, I had other activities where I didn't feel like a failure. Build an outside network of mentors and resources, especially if you're considering a non-academic career. Most advisors can really only speak to their own career experience, so whether you're leaving academic research or you hope to run your own lab one day, you need to meet and network with others outside of your university. I recommend platforms like Twitter to help you meet other scientists in a variety of career paths. Stick to your guns and be clear about your needs. Many advisors will have all kinds of cool new ideas and projects they want you to work on, but it's okay to say, no, I don't have time for that. Take care of yourself. Spend time with your friends and family as much as you can. I had a weekly dinner and D&D game night with friends that helped keep me sane because it meant that I had at least one night to relax every week. Make the time to prepare healthy meals to fuel your brain and body. Prioritize your sleep and get some exercise. I rode my bike to lab almost every day for 5 years, and just that 40 minutes of physical activity every day made such a huge difference. And if you have the resources, see a therapist. They can help you develop the skills you need to navigate grad school and keep you healthy and productive in all arenas of your life. You don't need to be having a crisis, and in fact, I think that most people would benefit from a regular mental health checkup with a therapist. I'm sure there's a lot of other great suggestions that I haven't included here. If you've got tips of your own from your grad school experience, I'd love to compile a more thorough list, so leave them down in the comments. Overall, I had an amazing grad school experience. I loved my lab and my advisor, and I had a fantastic project in an amazing research environment. I'm glad I had this experience, and I'm excited to be Dr. Astrocyte now. The key thing to remember is that grad school, and any job in STEM, is just that. It's a job. You shouldn't let your position consume your entire identity, so make sure you give yourself the time and space to be a person outside of the lab, and demand that others respect it too. You are more than your science, and you deserve to be treated that way. Until our next transmission, I'm Allie Astrocyte. Over and out.